The Rigidbody 2D is a component that allows a game object to be affected by 2D physics. The game object must also have a Collider 2D component attached to interact with other game objects using 2D physics. A Rigidbody 2D is required when working with specialized 2D physics components, such as 2D joints. The Rigidbody 2D is also used to define important physical properties about the game object, such as its mass, linear and angular drag, gravity scale, and other properties. It is worth noting that unlike 3D physics, the Rigidbody 2D has a gravity scale which allows gravity to be set on a per game object basis. In this scene, the prop ammo crate is a simple game object with a sprite renderer to hold and render the sprite. Enter play mode, and nothing happens. 2D physics behavior can be added to the ammo crate by attaching a Rigidbody 2D with add component, physics 2D, Rigidbody 2D. It is worth noting that there are other ways to attach a component to a game object. For more information on components and how to add them to game objects, please see the information linked below. When in play mode, the ammo crate now falls under the influence of gravity, but it does not collide with the spaceship. To interact with other game objects using 2D physics, all game objects involved need Collider 2D components, and at least one needs to have a Rigidbody 2D attached. The spaceship already has a 2D collider. A Collider 2D component can be added to the ammo crate by selecting Add Component, Physics 2D, Box Collider. The size of the 2D collider will automatically match the size of the sprite. In this case, the collider needs to be adjusted to match the image of the ammo box. Now, when in play mode, the ammo crate collides with and comes to rest on the top of the spaceship. For more information on 2D colliders, please see the information linked below. The Rigidbody 2D component not only allows a game object to be affected by 2D physics, it is used to define important physical properties about that game object. Mass is the mass of the Rigidbody 2D. 2D rigid bodies with higher mass, like those in the real world, take more force to move and will have greater effect when colliding with other 2D rigid bodies. In this first case, the ammo crate and the asteroid have the same mass. When the mass is changed on the asteroid, the interaction between the two game objects is significantly different. Linear and angular drag affect the velocity of 2D rigid bodies. Think of this as something similar to air resistance. Linear drag will slow the speed or velocity of the rigid body 2D. And angular drag will slow its rotation or angular velocity. Gravity scale controls how gravity affects the Rigidbody 2D. Unlike changing the global value of gravity, gravity scale allows for precise control on a per-game object basis. When in play mode, the ammo crate falls under the influence of gravity. Lower the gravity scale value, and the game object falls more slowly. To disable gravity, set this value to 0. When fixed angle is selected, the Rigidbody 2D will respond to 2D physics forces, but it will not rotate. Under normal conditions, the asteroid will fall, collide with the ammo box, and roll away. When fixed angle is selected, the asteroid will continue to react to physical forces, such as the collision, but it will not rotate. When IsKinematic is selected, The Rigidbody 2D is considered to be a kinematic Rigidbody 2D, and is not affected by 2D physics forces, including gravity and collisions. This is typically done when moving a game object with a 2D collider, without using physics or physics forces. For example, when creating a moving platform, the platform could be controlled by a script or animation, and be moved by its transform, not by physics forces. However, the platform needs to interact with other 2D game objects. So, the platform needs a 2D collider attached as well. This means there is now a moving game object with a collider 2D attached. When moving a collider 2D while the game is playing, it is highly recommended that a rigid body 2D be attached as well. Yet we don't want this platform to react to physics forces. In this case, the rigid body will be set to is kinematic. This platform is moved via scripting with a 2D collider attached. The interpolate settings can help smooth movement of a game object. If a game object appears to jitter when being moved via its rigid body 2D, use the interpolate settings to help smooth its transform movement. The interpolate setting will smooth the movement based on the game object's position in the previous frame. And the extrapolate setting will use the predicted position in the next frame. Sleeping mode controls how the rigid body will sleep to save processing time. Never sleep will disable sleeping. Start awake will make sure the rigid body 2D is awake when instantiated. Start asleep will initially set the rigid body 2D to sleep, but it can be woken by collisions. For more information on sleeping, please see the information link below. The collision detection settings control the type of collision detection used with a rigid body 2D. The default is discrete, and it is best to use discrete unless there are problems. In this case, collisions are registered if the game object's 2D collider is in contact with another during a physics update. Continuous is for fast-moving game objects, and collisions are registered if the game object appears to have collided with another between updates. For more information on Physics 2D and the Rigid Body 2D, please see the information linked below.